Hi there. As a student at Newcastle University, you're going to be doing a lot of writing. From assignments and reports to essays and dissertations, perhaps even a thesis. And that work will involve a great deal of research. Finding information, evaluating it, writing about it, and then referencing it. But what exactly is referencing, and why is it so important? Let's find out. All academic work builds upon the shared ideas, words, and findings of other people. This is the key to good research and allows people like you to base your work on the vast amounts of established knowledge that already exists. But whenever you use that knowledge, be it information from a book, journal article, newspaper, video, or website, you must acknowledge its source. In other words, you need to tell the readers of your work where you got the information from and who produced it. This is called referencing. But why is it such a big deal? Firstly, referencing makes it clear which information sources you've drawn on for your work. It places your writing in context and shows that it builds on the work of others. This makes any arguments or analysis that you present far more credible. It also proves you've taken the time to read around a subject, something your lecturers expect you to do and a surefire way to get you better marks. Secondly, referencing gives credit to the original author or creator of the information you've used. It shows you've borrowed their ideas and concepts. It also helps spread good work, connects important ideas, and contributes to the growing body of human knowledge. Thirdly, referencing allows assessors and other researchers to find and fact-check your sources, an important part of the academic review process. It also provides an easy-to-follow trail so that other readers can locate the sources you've used, should they want to learn more. Fourthly, referencing proves that you have what it takes to thrive as an independent researcher. It shows you can understand a question or problem and then find, analyse, and critically evaluate relevant sources to create your answer. These are key skills that both lecturers and graduate employers are looking for. And finally, there's another, even more important reason to reference. It helps distinguish your work from the ideas and contributions of other people. It shows which parts of your work are your own and which parts were inspired by others. And why is that important? Well, if you don't make this difference clear, or you forget or fail to reference your sources correctly, your own ideas won't stand out as clearly or get credit. At worst, you might even be accused of plagiarism, basically copying somebody else's work and passing it off as your own. This can have serious consequences, so you need to be careful. So that's referencing. It's not rocket science, but it is really important, and you do need to take it seriously. But don't get too stressed about it either. Just think of it as a way to give credit where credit's due, to acknowledge the ideas and information that inspired your work. You'll also get to show off how much background reading you've done, the different sources you've used, and just how proactive a learner you really are.